हेलो फ्यूचर डॉक्टर्स, वेलकम टू दिपेनिज्म। आई एम डॉक्टर दिपेन शाह और आज हम लोग डिस्कस करने वाले अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट, दैट इज फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ यूरिन फॉर्मेशन। नाउ फिजियोलॉजी का मतलब होता है स्टडी ऑफ नॉर्मल फंक्शंस, चाहे वो फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन हो, फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ सर्कुलेशन हो, या फिर फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ यूरिन फॉर्मेशन, दैट इज अ नॉर्मल फंक्शनिंग दैट इज परफॉर्म बाई किडनीज। Now, urine formation ka process occurs in three stages, three steps. That is the first step, ultrafiltration. Second is selective reabsorption. And third is tubular secretion. First step, jo hum log aaj discuss karne wale, that is about the ultrafiltration. Jab filtration occurs under very high pressure. And that is why it has been called as the ultrafiltration. Now, फर्स्ट पॉइंट दैट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर इज दैट ये अल्ट्राफिल्ट्रेशन का प्रोसेस जो है, दिस प्रोसेस इज अ फिजिकल प्रोसेस। एंड ये फिजिकल प्रोसेस जो होगा दैट विल ऑकर इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द नेफरॉन, दैट इज ग्लोमेरुलस प्लस बॉमन्स कैप्सूल टुगेदर, एंड दैट इज नोन एज द मैल्फिजियन बॉडी। सो दिस स्टेप ऑकर्स इन द मैल्फिजियन बॉडी विच इज अ फिजिकल प्रोसेस। I would request all of you to watch the entire structure of nephron. One of my video has been posted. So once you understand the structure of nephron, it will be easier to understand the entire process. So, Malpighian body mein, ye physical process jo hoga for ultrafiltration, it is occurring because of three different reasons. The first reason is the difference in diameter. So when you observe this structure has a wider diameter and this structure is narrower, and this incoming arteriole is known as the afferent arteriole, which is comparatively wider in diameter as compared to the arteriole which is taking the exit, that is known as the efferent arteriole. So afferent arteriole is wider, whereas efferent arteriole is comparatively narrower. And because of this difference of pressure, when blood enters into afferent arteriole, it enters under very high pressure. But when it exits under low pressure, and that is why yahan pe blood collect ho jayega into the glomerular capillaries. And once the blood gets collected, yahan pe jo pressure generate hoga, that we call it as GHP. GHP means glomerular hydrostatic pressure. And that is because of the difference of the diameter of afferent and efferent. This glomerular hydrostatic pressure ka value is around 55 millimeter of Hg, which can increase up to 70 to 75 millimeter of Hg as well. Then the second reason which is responsible for ultrafiltration is the glomerular capillaries itself. These glomerular capillaries are around 500 to 1000 times more porous than any other capillaries of the body, and since in mein zyada porosities hai, iske liye substances will be getting will be filtered, and filtrate jo collect hoga, that will be collect in this space which is known as the capsular space between the outer and the inner wall of the Bowman's capsule. The third reason for the ultrafiltration are these specialized cells. In my video of structure of nephron, these specialized cells ke bare mein discuss kiya gaya in detail. These specialized cells are known as the podocytes. So these cells are the podocytes which are having filtration slits or pores, and the substances will be filtered through these podocytes and they will be collected in the capsular space. So basically, ये जो filtration हो पा रहा है, that is being carried out because of a combination of different pressure, जिसमें first pressure which is responsible for ultrafiltration is glomerular hydrostatic pressure. So that is the main pressure responsible for the process. But दो additional ऐसे pressures हैं जो इस glomerular hydrostatic pressure को oppose करते हैं, and that is why we have mentioned over here a minus symbol. तो वो अपोज करेंगे टू ग्लोमेरुलर हाइड्रोस्टेटिक प्रेशर, एंड दोज टू प्रेशर आर बीसीओपी एंड सीएचपी। बीसीओपी इज नोन एज द ब्लड कोलोइडल ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर। सो ब्लड के अंदर देर आर सर्टन कोलोइडल प्लाज्मा प्रोटीन्स जो अपोज करेगा ये ग्लोमेरुलर हाइड्रोस्टेटिक प्रेशर को। सिमिलरली, जैसे जैसे कैप्सुलर स्पेस में फिल्ट्रेट कलेक्ट होते जाएगा, इवन दैट इज गोइंग टू अपोज, और ग्लोमेरुलर हाइड्रोस्टेटिक प्रेशर को इतना इजीली फिल्टर करने नहीं करेगा, नहीं हेल्प करेगा. सो दैट सीएचपी इज नोन एज कैप्सुलर हाइड्रोस्टेटिक प्रेशर. सो दैट इज द फिल्ट्रेट इन द कैप्सुलर स्पेस, दैट इज नोन एज कैप्सुलर हाइड्रोस्टेटिक प्रेशर. तीनों के जो वैल्यूज है, ग्लोमेरुलर हाइड्रोस्टेटिक प्रेशर उसका वैल्यू उन्होंने ऑलरेडी मेंशन कर लिया, दैट इज अराउंड 55 मिलीमीटर ऑफ एचजी. एंड ब्लड कोलॉइड ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर का वैल्यू इज अराउंड 30 मिलीमीटर ऑफ एचजी. And capsular hydrostatic pressure is around 15 millimeter of Hg. So overall the value is 55 minus 45, that is 10 millimeter of Hg. And this final value jo hum logo ko mila hai, this is known as EFP. EFP means effective filtration pressure. So effective filtration pressure is around 10 mm of Hg. And because of all this pressure, जो fluid यहाँ पे collect हो जाएगा after the filtration is known as the glomerular filtrate. Now, जो blood यहाँ से filter होके capsular space में collect हो रहा है, उसमें you have to remember कि glomerular filtrate में blood के cells are never filtered. RBCs, WBCs and platelets, इनका filtration कभी नहीं होगा. So what is filtered from the blood is specifically plasma. So it is only the plasma which is being filtered and glomerular filtrate ka formation ho raha hai. Plasma ka har ek component filter ho sakta hai except the plasma proteins. So glomerular filtrate ko we mention it as plasma minus plasma proteins, or we also call it as deproteinized plasma. So this deproteinized plasma is the glomerular filtrate. Now glomerular filtration rate jo hoga, that is known as GFR, that value you have to remember, which is 125 ml per minute. Ek minute mein itna filtrate yahan pe collect hoga, so that is the glomerular filtration rate. And agar usko calculate kiya jaye for an entire day, the value comes to around 180 liters per day. So remember future doctors ke pure din mein the filtrate collected is 180 liters. But urine formed is not 180 liters. Urine formed is hardly 1 to 1.5 liters. That means वो बाकी सब जो filtrate में useful substances होंगे, they are going to be selectively reabsorbed. The second step is going to be selective reabsorption. For your NEET exams, this is a very important point कि glomerular filtrate is deproteinized plasma. Also, the GFR value you have to remember. The effective filtration pressure, कौन-कौन से pressure unit से कौन help कर रहा है, कौन oppose कर रहा है, ये आप लोग को याद करना है for your entrance exam. Another important point that you have to remember के जो blood यहाँ पे आ रहा है, that amount of blood reaching the kidneys is around 1200 ml per minute. So this is the quantity of blood which is reaching the kidneys. So this blood में से the filtration part is the plasma part, और उसका value जो आता है that is around 650 ml per minute. So this 650 ml का value is known as RPF, that is known as renal plasma flow. So blood reaching the kidneys per minute is 1200 ml, but the renal plasma flow is 650 ml per minute. So this is an additional point for your entrance exams. In my next segment, we'll be discussing about the additional steps of urine formation. Stay tuned for my further videos. That's all from The Painism.